This is part 6 in my series on stock analysis with Python, and you can find links to those first 5 videos, as well as to the GitHub repository with the code in the description. Okay, so we had left off last time plotting closes a couple of different ways from selected stocks, and we had done that based on some data that was downloaded and saved into some folders. And this time what I want to do is take kind of a different swing at getting data and maybe using it with Excel. All right, so we're going to write a function called getReturnData. It's going to take in at a minimum a single ticker, but as many as you want, either separated by commas or some other Python collection object. All right, we're going to have a date, and then we're going to allow them to either use the close or the adjusted close, and then we'll save it out to an Excel file and allow the user to store this in a variable as well. All right, so the first thing I'm going to need to do then is set up my API client. Okay, and as I have been doing, I'm using this end of day historical data. All right, so you would have to replace that key variable with your API key. Next, I'm going to make a temporary data frame to store the data we download into. All right, and then I'm just going to start looping over those tickers that have been passed in. All right, and I want this to kind of end elegantly, so I'm going to use a try and accept here. All right, so we'll try, and then first we need to know if they want adjusted close or close. All right, so when it's adjusted close, we're going to append into this ticker column the result of this data frame that we get from this API call. Okay, that line's getting a little long, so I'll break it up here. All right, and we'll go from whatever the date is that's passed in. All right, and then I want the adjusted close column. Okay, otherwise, we'll just get the close, and it's pretty much the same. So let me copy that, paste it here, and then just update the column name. Okay, and then okay, our exception, we'll just print off some message. Okay. All right, so now we've downloaded as much data as we can. We've saved it into a data frame, and now we're ready to, right, do whatever transformation we want to do and then write it out to an Excel file. So I'm just going to make a new variable. I'll store our temporary data frame in there. We will get the instantaneous rate of return. Okay, I'm going to use NumPy to do this. And then we'll drop that first row. Okay, and then we'll get the regular percent change. All right, and we'll use a built-in method to do that. Okay, so now we're ready to go ahead and write this data out to a file. All right, I'm going to use the context manager here and then Pandas Excel writing object. All right, so this one's going to require us to put in the file name. And then yeah, we can put in a date format if we want to save it out to ISO. And then we're just going to take each one of those variables and insert it into this returns file. All right, and I should note also that you don't need Excel installed for this writer to work. All right, if you want to read it, then you would. All right, but otherwise, yeah, you can use this whether or not you have Excel installed on the computer you're using. All right, and then here we're going to have to give it the sheet name. Okay, and then yeah, we'll print some kind of message that this has happened. All right, and then, yeah, we might as well return these in a tuple. Okay, let's see if I can do that without making any mistakes. All right, I have set it up to download from these 4 tickers. All right, and then we should see the file appear over here, and then I'll also return the closing prices. All right, so let's try that. And, yep, I forgot an equal sign. Where is that? Here it is. Okay, let's try one more time. Yeah, and it does take a little bit of time, but okay, there's our file. I can't open it from here, right? If I want to fire up Excel, I'll see what happened. All right, and then here's the at least 10 rows of the data that we downloaded. Okay, so that's going to do it for part 6. In part 7, we're going to take a look at how we can plot all the performances in one single figure.